Welcome to Animal Based In Your Face. Today, we're gonna be making pork panko. Now, pork panko is one of our main ingredients in almost all of our recipes. It replaces flour. We're gonna be making it in this Breville food processor, and we're gonna show you why we do it this way. If you go to buy the pork panko already chopped up, it's gonna cost you about $4 more than this whole container. And this whole container right here, we can chop up ourselves and save $4. If you're not worried about saving $4, go buy the pork panko. Now, in our food processor, we're gonna need the processing blade. That's the big blade that comes with all the accessories. And then we're going to pour our pork rinds in here, and it's probably gonna take a couple of times to do it. I'm just gonna fill it to the top there. This bad boy on, power on, and you can just actually pulse, unless you just wanna run it. Now you've got finely grated pork panko that you use in place of flour. Okay, I dumped my pork panko out of here. This is the first batch, and you can see how much it makes this container. Now, one thing you have to watch out for when doing your own is you get these little hard pieces sometimes, but they pretty much just kind of do like this, and you'll see them. So we only had a couple in this batch. Those are a little bit hard. I mean, you can chew them, but we just don't like them. So we're going to put some more in.
That's a 16-ounce, 1-pound container that we purchased from Sam's Club.
And one thing you want to be careful with is why I use the pulse on here mode, is if you do them for too long, they'll get mushy.
And oily.
Yeah. I kind of like to pulse because it chops them, and then as they fall, it's almost like stirring. All right. And you don't have to take the blade out when you're doing this or anything until the last batch. Pour them in there.
Now, we like to keep our pork rinds in our Rubbermaid airtight container, and Scott's gonna show you how that works.
There was a hard one right there. They pretty much come right to the top when you do that. Those are all good? Yes, this is amazing. That presses on with that seal, locks down. Look at that. Now this one is the
Rubbermaid,
and it is a 9.6 cup. So you can see how many cups. We're probably gonna have about 8 cups of our pork panko from one of these 16-ounce jugs. Take out the blade. All right, we did the whole container. As you can see, that's what the whole container makes in pork panko. It really breaks it down. But here is the savings cost. This container is $6.98 at Sam's Club. The Walmart pork panko that's already done like this is gonna cost you $7.98. And it's only a 12-ounce container. This is 16 ounces of pork panko. You're talking a difference of $4. So you can save $4 by doing your own. And like you say, see, it literally took 3 to 5 minutes. Now, you could just keep it in this container. It's airtight. It would be fine. These last about 90 days. If you open this up, it lasts 90 days. So this will last 90 days.
You need to keep it in a cool, dry place and make sure it's airtight so it doesn't absorb moisture.
And I did go ahead and measure this out because this was a 9-cup container. It wasn't completely full. This actually came out to 7 cups exactly. So you get 7 cups of pork panko to use for your recipes. And again, with the pork panko, this replaces flour for all your recipes. We don't need any flour, gluten, basically. So even if you're not on an animal-based or carnivore or keto diet and you're allergic to gluten, this is a great option right here. Now, if you're making waffles, we make waffles with this all the time. If you don't, you know, you think this would have a porky kind of taste because it is pork, it doesn't. When you put a little Ceylon cinnamon and vanilla in that recipe, the taste completely goes away. It's like a bakery. It tastes like it has flour in it. You can coat chicken nuggets. Look at that recipe that's on our channel. You can make fried fish with this. I mean, there's just so many things. Pretty much anything that you use flour for, this will substitute. Be sure and subscribe. Hit that little bell up at the top so that you get all of our notifications when we make new videos. We try to make a couple of videos a week. Like us, follow us on Facebook. We have a private group where we help people and give some support and answer questions. It's called Animal Based In Your Face Tribe. Look it up, join. Till next time, we're going to go make some delicious recipes with this yummy, delicious pork rind bacon. Till then.